Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the .NET MAUI Daytime Range Selector Control. Using the .NET MAUI Daytime Range Selector, you can select a range of values from a specified dataset. In this video, I will show you how to add the Daytime Range Selector Control to a .NET MAUI application. I will also demonstrate how to add content, set minimum, maximum, and range values, and add labels, tooltips, ticks, and dividers. Before you begin, make sure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. Once you have installed the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application and provide a project name and location. Here, I'll proceed to create the project with the .NET 7.0 framework. Now the project is ready. Before I move forward, let's take a quick detour to set up the environment for running our application. Here, I choose an Android emulator. For this demonstration, I will select the Pixel 5 Android emulator. Once the emulator is selected, I'll run the application and show you the default output. The application has started compiling the default code, so let's wait for a few seconds. And now the application's homepage is displayed. Next, I will show you how to incorporate a SyncFusion.NET MAUI Daytime Range Selector into this application. I open the NuGet Package Manager. Search for the SyncFusion MAUI Sliders package and install it in my application. It will take a few seconds to complete the installation. Once the package is installed, I need to register the SyncFusion Core Handler to map the cross-platform API to the native Vue API. So, open the MAUI program file and add SyncFusion MAUI Core Hosting. Then register the handler by adding the configure SyncFusion core method. To use the SyncFusion MAUI controls, it's necessary to register a trial license key. I can do this by opening the appxaml.cs file. Add the register license method and enter the trial license key. To find out where to generate the trial license key, you'll find a link to instructions in the description below. Next, I navigate to the main XAML page and remove the default scroll view related code. Then import the SyncFusion MAUI sliders namespace. And I initialize the control by adding the SF Daytime Range Selector tag. Then, I press the F5 key to run this application. See, the default Daytime Range Selector is rendered, and you can drag the thumb to select a range. Now, I will show you how to add content to the range selector. You can add any content like charts, images, and so on. I prefer a Cartesian chart. To use the chart, I open NuGet Package Manager. Search for the SyncFusion MAUI Charts package and install. It will take a few seconds to complete the installation. I navigate to the main XAML page, then import its namespace here. Also to the local XML namespace, I map the default project namespace, Maui Project. I have included the Cartesian chart code here. Notice, here I have rendered the spline area series and set the visibility of the X and Y axis to false. Also, I have added the model and view model class to populate chart data. To learn more about adding a Cartesian chart, please check the Getting Started video in the card above and description below. Alright, let me show you the selector now. The range selector is rendered with the Cartesian chart. When you select a range, the chart region is also selected. To identify range values and enhance the readability of a range selector, you can show labels. To show them on this selector, I enable the Show Labels property. Also, I set the height of the selector to 210 pixels. And the selector renders with labels. However, you may notice that the labels in the tracks are congested. If you want to customize the track range and intervals in the selector, you can use the properties minimum, maximum, and interval among others. For example, if you want to represent the custom range on the slider with an interval of 2, just set the minimum value to January 1, 2022. And the maximum value to March 1, 2023. The current values of the range selector can be set by the range start and range end properties. I set the range start to March 1, 2022. And range end to January 1, 2023. Since I'm going to show the slider values in months, set the interval type to months. And the interval to 2. Check now, the track is customized based on the provided values, and the thumb is drawn corresponding to these range start and range end values. If you want to apply formats to the slider labels, you can use the date format property and set its value to a custom month-year format. And here, the month-year format is applied to the labels. Next, let's enable the tick lines for the selector. To do that, I enable the showTicks property in the control. You can also add minor ticks between major ticks by adding the minor ticks per interval property and setting its value to 1. Now, the major tick lines are shown on the slider track, and the minor ticks are shown in between the major ticks. By default, the selector's highest value is shown on the right and the lowest value on the left. If you want to inverse the selector, then enable the isInversed property. Thus the selector renders with the highest value on the left side and lower values on the right side. You also have another option to describe the values selected during the interaction using a tooltip. To demo, I add the DateTime Range Selector tooltip property. And include the slider tooltip. Checking now, a tooltip is shown for the selected years. Next, I will show you how to divide the range selector using shapes to represent the major interval points. To do that, I enable the Show Dividers property. To customize the active and inactive radius of the divider, I add a divider style property. Then, I defined the slider divider style with the active radius property at 4. And inactive radius at 6. See, the dividers are shown for major interval points. And the radius of the divider is increased based on the provided values. Finally, I will show you how to select track values discretely. To do that, I include the step duration property and set its value to 0,2. Here, 0 represents the year count and 2 represents the month count. And now, the values are selected discretely based on 2 months. In this video, I have shown you how to create a .NET MAUI application and add the Syncfusion MAUI Datetime Range Selector control with a few of its basic features. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, giving you a free license key to use all our .NET MAUI products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.